नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल एंड फाइन. लेट्स स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5, बर्ड्स बीक्स एंड क्लॉज. चिल्ड्रन, इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बर्ड्स. नॉट ओनली दिस, वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द एक्टिविटी गिवन इन दिस चैप्टर ऑल्सो. सो द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर हैज़ बीन कंप्लीटेड प्रीवियसली, बट वंस अगेन आई वॉन्ट टू recapitulate all the things whatever taught in my previous class. Let's start with the activity we had done in my previous class, that is to write the name of the bird, then the place where you saw it, and then the food it used to eat. This you have to write. I hope all of you had done this activity in your book. So children, this very time we are going to learn about the beaks. Birds do not have teeth. They use their beaks to tear, bite, chisel or crush the food. The shape of the beak is according to the food habit of the bird. So children, as we discussed in our previous class, that many birds are having different kind of beaks, and these beaks are according to their food habits. Suppose that some birds used to eat grains, but some of the bird also eat flesh and meat. So that beaks were styled like those food habit, means the shape of the beak is according to the food habit of the bird. Some bird use their beaks to fight the enemy or catch the prey. Prey means their food. They also use for preening their feathers. Now the word preening, whatever you have got in your homework, yes, it was preening. And preening is the process to clean the feathers and set them right. This activity is done by the bird itself, and the bird spread the wax secreted at the base of the feathers during this process. Yes, this is preening. Preening means set their feathers right. Yes, birds look always beautiful and set in a set well way. So this is because of the process of preening, and they do not need any barber, any other. So they can use their beaks to preen themselves, and it means to clean the feathers and set them right. The birds spread the wax secrete at the base of the feathers during this process. So this process is called preening. And they use their beaks to preen their feathers, means to set their feathers. Now we are going to start to learn about different kind of beaks as well as different kind of birds also. Let's have a look on a given picture. The first picture is of sparrow. The second is pigeon. The third one is parrot. So now let's see which kind of beak these birds are having. The beak is called crushing beak. Crush, you know, crushing. Birds like sparrow and pigeon have a short and hard beak. Yes, they are having short and hard beak. They use it for crushing seeds and grains. Grains are hard, and these birds, with the help of their short and hard beaks, crush the grains and thereby make them soft before eating. So in this way they are having crushing beaks, because these kind of beaks help them to crush the grains. Grains are comparatively harder than other prey. So these kind of beak, short and hard beaks, help the sparrow and the pigeon to crush the grains. Now let's learn about curved beak. Curved means turn. Birds like parrot have a curved beak. Let's have a look. Yes, it is having a curved kind of beak. This helps them in cracking nuts and fruits. Look at the curved beak. Yes, this kind of beak help them in cracking nuts. Nuts are there inside their cover, and such kind of beaks help them to crack the nuts as well as the food also. Now let's go to the next kind of beak, that is piercing and tearing beak. Some birds like eagle and vulture. Look at the picture. Yes, this is the picture of eagle. Okay, next one. Yes, this is the picture of vulture. Both the birds are having piercing and tearing beak. Why do they have like this beak? Because such kind of birds eat flesh, and such birds have a strong, hard and curved beak. So this piercing and tearing beak is strong, hard and curved also. That helps them to tear the flesh. Do you know? There are some birds which can imitate our voice, like parrot. Yes, parrot is a capacity to imitate our voice. The second fact is crows and hens have beaks that help them to eat a variety of foods like meat, fruits, grains and insects. Means they used to eat different kind of foods, different kind of prey like meat, fruits, grains and insects. Now let's move to the next type of beak, that is chiseling beak. Chiseling beak, let's have a look. Yes, birds like woodpecker. Woodpecker here have a strong, long and a straight beak. This helps them to peck at the wood and eat insects present in the wood. So children, what does this woodpecker use to eat? Yes, you are right. The insects present in the wood. That's why they are having strong, long and straight beak. And this kind of beak help them to peck the wood and eat the insects present inside the wood. Look at the picture of woodpecker. Yes. Do you know, while pecking at something, a bird moves its beak forward quickly and bites it at. So this is a style of woodpecker. Now let's know about probing beak. What is probing beak? Some birds like the hummingbird, smallest bird, you know, then the sunbird and the hoopoe have a long and slender beak. Comparatively, this bird are small in size, but their beak are too long. Why? Because sunbird sucks nectar from flowers, while hoopoe takes out insects and worms from the holes in the ground. So this is very new thing about the birds. Look at them. The hummingbirds, small birds having long beak, And here one more bird in the picture, that is Hoppo. The hummingbird can flap its wings 90 times in just 1 second. What an interesting fact it is. A hummingbird can flap its wings 90 times in just 1 second. So, this is the fact behind hummingbird. Sunbird sucks nectar from flowers, while Hoppo takes out insects and the worms from the holes in the ground. Here, hummingbirds is sucking nectar from the flower. You can see in the picture that is given very clearly. Okay, now here, look at its beak. It's also long and sharp, which it used to takes out insects from and worms from the holes in the ground. So its long beak helps to do so. Now let's go to the next kind of beak, that is sifting beak. Sifting beak. The duck has a flat and broad beak. Look at the beak of duck. Okay, yes, we are able to see the beak of duck. It is looking flat, yellow in color, with a hole. The duck has a flat and broad beak, which has small holes on both sides. It digs up the food along with mud, because it used to live or swim in the water. Yes, right. From the base of the pond or lake, it beak pushes out the mud and water from the holes, leaving the food behind. It beaks thus help it to sift food from mud and water. So in doing this activity, the two holes that is there in the beak of this duck helps her in sifting the mud water from its food. So those two holes helps us in doing so. And its beak pushes out the mud and water from the holes, and it leaves the food inside its mouth or inside its beaks, which it's used to eat. This beak thus helps to sift food from mud and water. Yes, now let's move to the another kind of beak. That is sticky beak. Sticky beak. Look at the picture of swallow. Very small beak it is having. Look at the beak. Sharp but small. But it is looking strong also. Now, let's see. A swallow has a small, broad and sticky beak. The beak is sticky from inside. Not from outside, but inside. The beaks of this swallow is sticky, and this kind of beak helps the swallow to catch flies while flying. So that flies used to stick in the beak of this swallow, and it used to catch flies while flying. So this is the speciality of sticky beak. Do you know? The arrival of flocks of swallows is a sure sign that summer is on its way. Means if there is a group or there is a flocks of swallows we used to see, then it indicates that the summer is coming. So this is the explanation about different kind of beaks. Children, let's have a look. First one is crushing beak. Second is curved beak. Third is piercing and tearing beak. Fourth is chiseling beak. Fifth is probing beak. Sixth is sifting beak. Seven is a sticky beak. Okay. So these are the fact about the beaks. In this way, we have all learned about the different kind of beaks. And we all learn about different kind of birds also, which are having different kind of beaks. And those beaks are according to their food habits. Children, now I am going to give you some homework. You must do that. That preening is given you in previous class. In this class, you have to write that do you know in your copy. Here is a do you know on page number 33. Then again, do you know in page number 34. And then again, you have to write this do you know about sticky beak or swallow bird. So this is your homework, children. One more thing I would like to explain here is the keywords. One more time, here I am going to explain you the keywords. First word is chisel. Chisel means a flat blade with a cutting edge. Second is feather, means light, horny, waterproof structure on the body of birds. Then third is hollow. Hollow means vacant space in something. The fourth word is pierce. Pierce means to cut through. The fifth one is probe. Probe means to find out. And the last one is sift. Sift means to separate out things using a sieve. Yes, sieve is used to separate out things. So this is the keywords given in your book. You must learn this keyword. And you must write the do you know whatever given in your homework. Thank you.